founder here at the Booth Centre. As you can see, I'm in our comfy corner, but the sofas have gone because when we reopen, we aren't going to be able to have three people sat on the sofa because we're going to have social distancing in place. So we're getting the centre ready, and we've got chairs a lot more spread out now. So when you come back into the centre, we'll be able to keep everybody safe. So for now, the centre's still closed, but you can come to the garden if you need any emergency advice and support, Monday to Friday between 9 and 12. And otherwise, keep in touch through the texting service. Send us a text message, let us know how you are, and pick up the phone to our phone calls. We'd love to have a chat with you. We really like to keep in touch. And keep busy using the activity packs and the suggestions in those. And remember to enter the competitions. Thom will tell you more about those later on. And look forward to seeing you all soon when we're able to reopen. Bye for now. Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Amanda, and yes, I am Thom. I'm going to be taking us through our weekly art pack of fun, excitement and joy, as usual. We've got our bee artwork, which yesterday you may have saw me doing a little bumblebee. Obese bee, somebody might have called it yesterday. I think that was a pretty fair comment. Look at him, he's a little round ball. But yeah, anyway, that's a vital piece of information there you might need to remember. Because we are running the bee competition, aren't we? It's on our postcards. We're asking everybody to send in the postcards, which we sent out in our packs. Stick on the answer to the question, where do bees live? What did I just say a moment ago? Write that on the card, send it in. You could be in with winning a tenner. Every week we're giving away a tenner to one lucky person. So yeah, if you send it in, you've got a better chance of winning. Good news, that, isn't it? I think as well, as it was our 25th the other day. Sorry, the Booth Centre's 25th birthday, wasn't it? I think next week we're going to be doing the theme of 25. I'm sure we'll figure out what we're going to be drawing around that at a later date. But I hear it's going to be a £25 prize for that one. There you go, so that'll be worth sticking around for, won't it? So yeah, everybody keep on getting your art drawn on these little postcards and sent in to us at the Booth Centre. So whilst we're on this bee theme, you know, I thought I'd get some inspiration for us all. Some ideas of what bee themed stuff we could do. I did the Manchester Bee the other day, I did a comedy, honey, Winnie the Pooh style hive and some big old round bees. So today we're going to go through a list of amazing bee facts and see if it gives us any hints or tips as to what we could be drawing on our postcards. So let's just start at the top, eh? Did you know honeybees must gather nectar from 2 million flowers to make 1 pound of honey? So a pound of honey is like enough to put in like a honey jar. So about, I think it's 450 grams. So not a lot. Yeah, like probably just a bit more than a cup full. 2 million flowers they gather it from. crazy amount of numbers. So that most of these are just astonishing numbers. But yes, so what could we take from that one? Honeybees must gather nectar from 2 million flowers. You just draw a bee surrounded by billions of flowers. Well, not billions, millions would be fine. So yeah, couple of little bees and then loads and loads and loads of flowers. That'd be a good postcard. That'd look cool on the back of one of these, wouldn't it? Next one, what else could we get inspiration from? So one bee has to fly about 90,000 miles, 3 times around the globe, that is, to make that pound of honey. So if one bee was to do it all, he'd have to fly around the world 3 times so that we could just have that one jar of honey. These guys, you can see why they're called worker bees, or we use it as a sign for Mancunians being strong and powerful workers, don't you? Because look how much work these bees put in just to make our honey. Craziness. The average bee will make only 1/12 of a teaspoon of honey in its lifetime. So he lives all that time and he makes 1/12 of a teaspoon. we're taking from these a bit too much by the sounds of it. So yes, you could just draw an extremely tired bee. It'd be quite nice to, for them to know that we appreciate how much work they're putting in. Number four, so a honeybee visits 50 to 100 flowers in a collection trip. So every time he nips out, like when we go to the shops or whatever like that, he's going out, but he has to go between 50 and 100 different flowers. Crazy. Maybe you could draw a bumblebee coming back from his trip with loads of shopping bags. Everybody's been there. Everybody knows how bee is when you've got dead heavy shopping bags and they're cutting into your fingers. You could draw a bee doing that. All different varieties of bee in Thom's weird surreal world. Number five, a honeybee can fly for up to 6 miles at 15 miles an hour. So 6 miles, what's that? That's from like town to like Oldham, maybe? Is that about 6 miles? Things about that far, it's not too far, is it? So it's walkable in a couple of hours, but yeah, that's a long way for a tiny little bee to do. And at 15 miles an hour, I suppose he's doing it pretty fast, isn't he? Next one, that's what you draw there, super speedy bee. In like, on a sports bike, something like that, just zooming around. Number six, the bee's brain is oval in shape and about the size of a sesame seed, yet it has a remarkable capacity to learn and remember things. For example, it is able to make complex calculations on distance travelled and foraging efficiency. So what that means is they remember where they've been, they remember where they've seen lots of food, and they can go back to it. So not many animals are that clever. They just go out and they're just on a random, I don't know where I'm going, I'm just trying to find anything. But not bees. They go out, they find a good source and like, I'm going to remember that until, and I'm going to milk it until it's all gone. And so sometimes I think they even do that and tell the mates, like communicate somehow. So that one there, that'd be a good brain box bee. You could do a very clever bee, like a scientist type bee or something like that, or a teacher style bee. Teaching people, you know, those mortar boards that you get when you go to, when you graduate uni. There we go, yeah. This is how they communicate. Honey bees communicate with one another by dancing. There you go, you could draw some bees in a disco. Simple, like one of those checkered floorboards that flashes up like in the 70s. Massive afro ones, maybe some roller skates. A colony of bee consists of 20 to 60,000 honeybees and one queen. Worker honeybees are female. They live for about 6 weeks and do all the work. So they only live for about 6 weeks. Crazy, and yet they do all the work. So that's women. The women bees that are doing all the graft there. So yeah, you just do a tired out woman, female bee. Doing all the graft, doesn't say where the men are. Number nine, the queen bee can live up to 5 years and is the only bee that lays eggs. So in comparison to the other ones, which live 6 weeks, the queen bee does pretty well out of all this. 5 years. She's the busiest in the summer months when the hive needs to be at its maximum strength and lays up to 2,500 eggs per day. Whew, no wonder there can be up to 60,000 bees in a colony. If they're laying them at that speed, crazy, crazy, crazy. And finally, number 10, larger than the worker bees, the male honeybees, also called drones, have no stinger and do not work. All they do is mate. Don't think you'd be able to get away with that in human terms, would you? But yeah, they've no stinger and they do no work. You would definitely not get away with that in real life. So yeah, what you draw there, some lazy lazy men bees. Lazy dude bees, busy women bees. There you go, 10 amazing bee facts. And hopefully you got some sort of inspiration for what you could put on the back of your card. Because there's it doesn't always have to be a realistic. Like I just went through some daft ones there, it could be a bee on a roller skates, you know what I mean? Having a dance in a disco. All fun, isn't it? And it gets you creative, gets your mind thinking, so, which is what we're doing all this for, keeping you busy. So, lovely stuff. And next on my agenda, I went back to the centre yesterday, didn't I? And I met Richard, and he does have some new riddles for us after finishing off the last series. We've got a fresh set of riddles for you, so let's have a look at them.
Well, it's great to be back at the Booth Centre today, and here I am in Thom's filming studio to film some more riddles. I hope you've been enjoying them so far. I've got an exciting list here, and I would say try to focus on the key word. In each of these riddles, there's one or possibly sometimes two keywords that really give the game away. So, good luck. A cowboy rode into town on Friday. He stayed in town for 3 days and rode out on Friday. How is that possible?
Very good question. Came in on a Friday, stayed 3 days, so that make it Saturday, Sunday, Monday stayed, but he left on Friday. Maybe it was like one of them leap year weeks or something like that, where they do change the amount of dates, or maybe, yeah, I don't know, maybe he wasn't working off our calendar. I'm not sure. Many different answers and possibilities. Well, thank you very much, Richard. Look forward to seeing the answer tomorrow. Make sure you come back for Thursday's episode and we'll find out the answer to your riddles. Thank you, sir. And let's move on to our next part of the video. Next part, exercise. So we've all seen the exercises in the back of our activity pack. And what we're going to do now is take you through them. Let me whip it out before I start it up. We've got a very special guest. Of course, you know, I like to pull out all the stops. There's no messing around here on the Booth Centre Art Channel. Art Channel, whatever. Activity Pack Channel, that's what I was calling it. Probably should give it a proper name this series, innit? But I don't know, I'm just calling it Activity Sessions for now. So yes, here we go. It's Alix. I think I narrated this, so I'm just going to leave it.
Everyone away. Wave then. You look like a bloody samurai. Excellent. So, shoulders rotation. Place your legs at shoulder width. Keep your arms straight at your sides. Yeah. Perform both shoulders rotation clockwise and counterclockwise. it's like from a yeah, instruction manual, isn't it? Perform both shoulders rotation. Do it to the side so you can see the side profile. Yeah, nice. And it says to do it 10 times if you want, but you don't have to. I'm not going to drag this one out that long. Next one, torso swings. Stand with your legs straight. Place your feet at shoulder width. Bend your torso forward 90 degrees. Raise both arms straight to the outside. Perform the most extensive movements to the left and to the right. Look at the hand that you're lifting, that's the one, yeah. Nice. Next. Lunges. Take a big step forward with your right leg. Start to shift your weight forward so the heel hits the floor first. Lower your body until the right thigh is parallel to the floor and the right shin is vertical. Switch, that's the one. It's okay if the knee shifts forward a little, as long as it doesn't go past the right toe. Lightly tap the left knee to the floor while keeping the right weight on the right heel. So if you can get your knee, your other knee on the floor. That's interesting. Do you reckon? No?
No.
Press ups. Begin with your chest and stomach flat on the floor. You don't have to if you're just going to do girl ones. Yep. Oh yeah. Push on your hands. Bring your torso, chest and thighs off the ground. Slowly lower your back to starting position. Pike, come here.
Go.
Come here. Good boy. You're not supposed to, you're supposed to push up, stay straight. Yeah, do it girl, do girl ones. So yeah, keep yourself straight. Keep your back straight is what they want, it's just arms. That's the one.
That's too hard.
It is very hard, isn't it? Good work. Next, sit up, so stay down. Start by lying on the ground on your back. With your knees bent, yep. Pike, come on. and your hands behind your head. Keeping your feet glued to the ground. Begin to roll up from the head. Engaging your core throughout, yep, very good. Don't strain your neck in the upward motion. That's the one. That'll do. Right, walk, cool down now. And side squats, stride squats. Stand with the legs wide apart.
Did you move back
up again? No, I did. Stand with your legs wide apart, shift your weight to the left, and allow your left knee to bend until it is over your left foot. Keep your feet on the ground facing forward. Repeat the stretch on the opposite side. Hold for 10 seconds. Last one, it's the arm stretch. So take your right arm across your chest. Yeah? With the left hand, grasp the back of the part of the right upper arm. Keep the left elbow bent as you pull across. Hold it for 10 seconds, switch sides. Perform two sets on each side. So yeah, you could do it like guys do, like that. Finish, say goodbye and walk off.
Thank you very much, Alix. That was all a good bit of fun, wasn't it? Although it's hard. Alix obviously struggled on the press-ups a little bit, very much like I did yesterday. I've got no upper body strength either. But yeah, so I think what you'd recommend probably to do on those bits, definitely use the ones on your knees. If you're finding it a bit hard to do a proper traditional sit press up, use the old school method and get your knees on the floor and do it that way. I think I need to do a few more of them, and hopefully sooner or later I'll be able to do proper like exercise guy full on push-ups. Thank you very much there, Alix. Took us nicely through the little exercise section. Once we've done some exercise, you know what I like to do. I'm going to reach up here, get my headphones on, and I'm going to take us through another sing-along. My favourite part of these videos, you know it is. You all know that I like singing, really. Right, what have I got for us this time? Ah, yes. So I've got two great tunes. I've got one, which is from a musical. Not wrong with that, is it? And the other one is just a proper rock classic. I'm going to go for the musical first, and then we're going to go for the rock classic second. Build up to it. So yes, this first one, from a
good
piece.
One that I want.
You may know as Grease. By John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John.
I got chills. They're multiplying, and I'm losing control, because the power you're supplying, it's electrifying.
Oh, you came in.
You better shape up, because you need a man, and my heart is set on you. You better shape up. You better understand. To my heart, it must be true. There's nothing left for me to lose. You're the one that I want.
You are the one I want.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. in thee. If you're filled with affection, you're too shy to convey. You better take my direction, feel your way. Better shape up, 'cause you need a man who can keep you satisfied. You better shape up if you're gonna prove that your faith is justified.
Justified.
Oh yes, you know deep down, deep inside, you're the one that I want. You are the one I want. The one that I want. The one that I want,
you are the one I want.
The one that I need, oh yes indeed.
Oh yeah,
the one that I want. You are the one I want. Ooh, ooh, ooh. The one that I want, you are the one I want. Ooh, ooh, ooh. The one that I want, you are the one I want. Ooh, ooh, ooh. The one that I need.
Very much, boys. Cool ending there with that big long fat zoom on it.
Yeah, that was good.
I like that the other guy's backing vocals or whatever. I mean, he was doing the bare minimum, whatever, wasn't he? He was like, this is the famous "You are the one I want." Oh, like, you know the backing bits? Everybody knows it. He wasn't doing it though, was he? His choice, up to you, mate. Up to you. I'm not gonna judge. Next, I did say we had a rock classic from a little old band named Free. This one is All Right Now. Sung by a lady called Moira Cox. She plays it all as well. Have a look, she switches between bass and guitar, so she's playing both, which is pretty cool. And a killer shredding at the end.
She stood in the street, smiling from her head to her feet. I said, hey, what is this? Now maybe, maybe, maybe she's in need of a kiss. I said, hey, what's your name, baby? Maybe we can see things the same. Now don't you wait or hesitate. Let's move before they raise the
guitar. Can she do it? wasn't the full version, was it? But man, she could shred that guitar, couldn't she? Very impressive. I love it when someone can do that. Multi-instrumentalist, plays the guitar and the bass, and she sang all that. Excellent work. Excellent work indeed. I wish I could play a guitar or something like that. Now, I've got no musical knowledge in that sense. I can play the drums a little, basic rock drums, nothing too fancy, but I can't play any instrument, not keyboard, nothing like that. I tried to get in a school band when I was like 12 or something like that, and they gave me the trombone and I couldn't play it. I lasted about 3 weeks and then they kicked me out because I couldn't play the trombone. So that's about it for my musical trying, and then that's it. I just thought hitting things like sticks and pots and pans, more my style, that, isn't it? Anyway, that's talking pots and pans. That is a segue and a half I just created for myself there. Next up for you guys, you all have may noticed in our activity packs that we've got a microwave meal. Yeah, I suppose it's a microwave meal, yeah. So, this one, James's microwave recipes today. It was French onion soup. So, what I'm going to do is going to introduce you to my friend Thom in the kitchen, and he is going to take you through how to make microwave French onion soup. Alright, here we are, back in my kitchen, ready for a little bit more microwave cooking. I've got this cam, I've got my little handy cam down here, so let's get cracking. I've done a little bit of prep, I've chopped my onion already, didn't want you to see me crying on camera, so... Like they do in the proper chef programs, or pre-slice me onions. So let's jump into it, and it should be pretty plain sailing from here. So we're gonna melt some butter first. How much does it say? 2 tablespoons. So get it all down here. About that. That'll do me. It's a healthy amount, isn't it? Shing. Oh, into the bowl. Full power, 30 seconds. Boom. I could hear that started to sizzle a little bit towards the end. Almost melted completely there. I think that's good to go, isn't it? Banging my onions. Slice my onions nice and long like that, as you can see, so we'll get some nice long strands in the soup at the end. So yeah, I'll get a spoon on that to give it a mix. I'm going to get all this covered because it's going to cook now. If I can keep it in the bowl, that'd be good, wouldn't it? Right, I think that's mixed up and broken down enough. I'm going to put it in the microwave for 2.5 minutes, but we've got to get it out twice and give it a stir whilst it's cooking. So, 2.5 minutes. Actually, you know what I've got to do? I've got to make the water, mix it with my stock cube, mix it with my corn flour. So, I can get on with doing that, can't I? So it was like 3 cups. Let me get something to put it into. Three tap waters even. And salt and pepper. Go on then. We like a bit of salt. Salt to taste. Whatever the doctor's ordered. Oh, where's my salt grinder? Pepper grinder. Here it is. Got an empty one there. I like my pepper. Keep it peppery. Next, mix it in with your onions. Oh, they are very nice and soft. So I'm probably going to put my onions in there, you know? Yeah, it's nice and warm. Right, so I'll get those in there. So hopefully, it's going to be a delicious soup once we finish with this. It's looking, starting to look like a onion soup, doesn't it? Cover with cling film and paste the top. I don't think it's vital you use cling film, but if you've got it, use it. If not, sometimes just a plate covered on the top of it would work the same as cling film. But I've got some cling film, so I may as well use it. There's my cling film, paste the top a couple of times so it doesn't burst. Cook for what? 2 minutes and 30 seconds. Stir well. another time for a kick back.
Right, I've done a bit of tidy up. Let's do some of that cheese on toast on the top of it. It's not proper French onion soup without a bit of toast and cheese floating on the top. Lovely stuff, that's 2 minutes 30 on that. Let's have a look. Sure, if you want it to simmer down a bit, just take the top off and keep it in there for a little bit. Don't think you can really massively overcook one of these. Oh, it smells good. Yeah, I'm not going to rush it, I'm going to wait until I've got my toast. Some cheeky taste as we go. Pretty good actually. Bit more salt and pepper. Right, so we've got a piece of toast ready. What's it say to do? Toast the bread, cut it up into small pieces, so they do like it in like pieces of little croutony bits, don't they? So what size sheets the pieces shall I do it in, like little soldiers like that? No, maybe. Nah, 4 1/3. Let's go with thirds. Get into 9 little bits in total. So we've got our French onion soup. Let's get it on. We've got our cheese. So our final bit, we just serve it, put the cheese and toast on the top. 30 second blast. Boom. Dinner time. So what am I going to do? I just want a majority. I just want the onions out of this. Give it a good old stirring. Can we see this? Bring it around here for you. There we go. Looks like a delicious onion soup, doesn't it? Going for off it. Just give it a pour for you. I'm not as neat a server, am I? So I should use the fork to get these onions out of here. Seconds left and then we're done. Done a fair bit of cleaning up, so nothing to do after. A little bit of washing up, but it's worth it for my dinner. Things started to melt a little bit, as you can see around here. Oh, looking very French. Let's have a dig in, eh? What do you reckon? You're gonna go focus on that or not? Probably not. Ah well. Let's eat it. I'll use that spoon, see if I can wash it up, eh? Some onions in there, a bit of cheese in there, a bit of bread in there. Actually really good. That cheese in there really makes a big difference. Love it. Recommend it, try it at home.
Did look alright that, didn't it? I love the fact that I had loads of cheese and toast in my beard at the end of that section. Really classy boy, aren't I? So I hope everybody enjoyed today's episode. It's been a bit of good fun, hasn't it? With the beef facts and the inspiration for what we could have been drawing at home. We had the new series of riddles from Richard. We had some exercises from Alix proving that the exercises aren't as easy as you think. And everybody should be out there trying to get themselves fitter, because in this staying in situation, we're all just deteriorating. Getting weaker. I definitely am anyway. And then after that we had 2 classic songs. Bit of Grease. Well, from the film Grease, wasn't it? And All Right Now. Love that tune. Bit of shredding on the guitar. And yes, Chef Thom cooking some microwave French onion soup. So I do hope that was enough for everybody. Make sure you tune in tomorrow at 11 o'clock. I will be back with everybody else. Last day before the bank holiday weekend. So make sure you get your art done. Send it off to the booth centre because we'll be sending out a new pack later on this week. Don't know when exactly. It should be with you for next week though. And yes, it's the 25th anniversary pack. So special one. Keep your eyes out for that. So all I've got to say now, everybody stay safe. Stay home. Wash your hands. I've been Thom.